Assalamu alaikum everyone, I'm your computer teacher Fatima Haider and I really hope that you all are fine. First of all, I'm really glad that most of my champions have performed really well in the June assessment. So as you know that our midterm has just started and let's make these online classes as successful as we make the June assessment. So the midterm assessment started with the chapter number 3 about the CPU. As the name indicates, this chapter is related to the central processing unit. CPU stands for central processing unit. Have you ever seen the CPU? Mostly we are using the mobile phones, laptops and tablets as a form of computer, but once when the desktop was the only form of computers that we were used to have in at our homes or in our offices, then CPU was the most recognized part of the computer. In other words, you can say that CPU is called the brain of the computer. My question to you, what our brains do? What's the function of our brain? As you know that the brain of human being controls all the function of the body of human being. It processes all kinds of information that we get through the through our eyes. Through our eyes, when we see something, our brain processes that information and then in the minute, in seconds, it gives us the result. For example, if I touch something hot, if I touch some hot cup or a hot glass, then my brain processes that information and forbids me that please don't touch it. You will get harm. You would get hurt. So that's the function that my brain performs. My brain मुझे बताता है कि इस चीज को touch ना करो. इस चीज को touch करने से आपको नुकसान होगा. आपको ये गर्म लगेगा. So that's the thing the CPU does for a computer. CPU is a brain of the computer. It controls all the function of the computer. It processes all kinds of function of the computer. Whatever the data we enter into the computer with the help of any input device, just like the keyboard or the mouse or the scanner, the CPU is a part that processes that data and gives us the output that we can see or in our output devices, just like the monitor. For example, if I type my name, Fatima, F-A-T-I-M-A, with the help of the keyboard, the CPU will process that information and give me the result on the monitor. So let's read it out. What does the wonders that can we do with the help of the CPU? The central processing unit is the brain of the computer. The computer cannot function without it. So this is very important thing. This part is the most essential part for the function of the computer. If I detach my CPU with my desktop, then my desktop cannot work. It is same as that we cannot work without our brain. Just like can you work without your brain? No, you cannot read without your brain. You cannot write without your brain. You cannot do anything without your brain. So brain is the most essential part of your body. Similarly, the CPU is the most essential part of a computer. Right? The computer cannot function without it. The CPU controls and processes all the information in the computer. So it controls the things, it processes the things. It also directs and controls the flow of information out of the computers. Okay, just like it also connects the different part of the computer. For example, the wire of the printer is attached to the CPU. Meanwhile, the wire of the mouse, keyboard, and the monitors are also attached with the CPU. If I want to print any document, so CPU would be that part who controls the flow of the information. CPU would indicate the printer to print something. Aisa nahi hoga ke monitor direct printer ko kuch information karne ke liye. No, CPU would do that. You can say that it will exchange the information between the monitor to the printer. When I will enter a data with the help of the keyboard, then that I want to print, the computer will instruct the printer that please print that data. The CPU is housed on a single chip called microprocessor. Okay, so there is a small chip. You can see this chip. This is a small chip that is attached in the CPU. This is known as a microprocessor. It is located in the system unit. What is the function of this microchip? It can store a large amount of the data. The data that we can store in our computer is all the data that we have stored on our microchips. Most CPUs can execute between 1 million and 100 million instructions per second. Okay, so computer does wonder. A computer is a magical thing. Just like we human being, sometimes we can only do one thing at one time, but computer can do a lot of things at the same time. Computer can give instructions. It gives 100 million instructions per second at the same time. And just like you can do Microsoft Excel, you can do Microsoft PowerPoint, you can paint the things, you can search something on the Google in 1 minute. So computer works it's such a multitasking device that it can work a lot of things in just seconds. So these are the yes or no question you will do. I'm giving you 10 minutes. Number one, the CPU does not process data. I already told you, you will tell me the answer. The CPU directs the flow of the information from the computer to the printer. So this already I told you. The CPU does not enable a computer to function. The CPU is located in the scanner. So CPU is located in a scanner or not, you will tell me. Let's move to the other page. You can see this is the page number 20 on your book, and it tells us the most three important components of the CPU. Number one, ALU, arithmetic logical unit. Number two, CU, control unit. And the number three, MU, memory unit. First of all, we will take the arithmetic logical unit. As the name indicates, what can you guess about the function of the arithmetic logical unit? What can you guess? Arithmetic. As we know that mathematics or a math has a second name known as the arithmetic. So this part of the computer CPU deals with all the arithmetic calculations. It do all the plus, minus, multiply, divide, percentage, exponent, and various other mathematical function can be performed with the help of arithmetic logical unit. If this component will not present in the CPU, the human will not be able to perform the mathematical or arithmetical calculations or the logical things with the help of the computer. It also do wonders. Just like it can make a lot of data on the excel sheets or the mathematical sheets that we can perform with the help of arithmetic logical units is the most important thing that a CPU can do. So I can read it out for you. Arithmetic logical unit performs all arithmetic calculations such as addition, multiplication, and makes all logical decisions. Logical decisions, these are the analogous things, just like the stats thing, exponent thing, percentage things. Okay, so control unit. What's the function of control unit? As I already told you, that CPU, central processing unit, does not only process the information that we enter with the help of input devices, but on the other hand, it controls the information. It flows the information from one part of the computer to another part. I gave you an example earlier that if you want to print up a document, it will make a communication between the keyboard and the printer and the monitor, just like that you will enter your data with the help of the keyboard or the mouse, and they will firstly process the data, then will show the data on the monitor as an output device, and then it will instruct the printer to print that information. So it controls the communication or the coordination. If there will be no coordination between the different parts of the computer, so we cannot work properly. For example, if there will be the no communication or the coordination between the printer, monitor, and the keyboard, so you will not be able to do so. Next is, I can read it out for you. The control unit directs different parts of computer to carry out the instructions. It controls the communication and coordination between input output devices and computers. So it directs different part of computers, it controls the communication or the coordination between different parts of the computer. Next is the memory unit. What is the memory unit? What can you think about the word the memory? So memory unit stores data and instructions to process the data. We can store the information, we can store our data in the computer with the help of the memory unit. If this part of the CPU will not be there, we will not be able to store anything in the computer, we will not be able to process the data in the computer. So these were the three important components of the computer: arithmetic logical unit, control unit, and the memory unit. In the picture you can have the idea: arithmetic logical unit, control unit, and the memory unit. So input will, whatever we will input into the computer, just like the mathematical calculation, just like the if we want to print something, we want to scan something, so control unit will do. If we want to enter the data into the computer to save something, to store that data, then the memory unit will do so. And then the final thing will be shown to the output, though the output will be the monitor or the printer or something. So let's move to the page number 21, and you can see the identifying the words from the following minute. These are the blanks and the hints are the given. Number one, ways of sending information by using the technology. You will do this, I will help you out. Number two, organizing groups so they work together properly. Okay. And if you have read out the page number 20, then you can do this part very easily. Which part of the CPU is used for the following? So you have to tell the part of the CPU. I can give you one example. Number one, to calculate the total books an author has told. So in this part, we are going to calculate something. What was the part of the computer or the CPU that we will used for this purpose? So arithmetic logical unit, ALU, because it is connected, it is related to calculate something, it is related to add, multiply, subtract, etc. To get scanned copy of a picture. So to get scanned copy of a picture, we must connect the scanner with the help of with our some output devices. So for that purpose, the control unit will do so. To see a flight schedule on the monitor. Which was the part of the CPU that can store the data or the other thing? So the answer is the memory unit. As I told you, that memory unit is the component of the CPU that can store data. So for seeing the flight schedule on the monitor, just like our airports and our international flight companies usually schedule their flights and store their data and the computer, and the other viewer can see it. So memory unit. Last one, to retrieve data stored on the computer. So it is also related to the memory unit, because in this we can store the data or something. So that's all from my side for today's lecture. If you have any query, please feel free to ask me and do your homework and do your homework what I will give you. So thank you so much.